How's it going, everybody? Welcome back. And today I'm going to bring you guys a little tutorial so that you are able to use ExpressVPN to its fullest potential. Okay. So if you are a beginner and you're not exactly familiar with VPNs, the tips that I'm going to give and the explanations about the features that I'm going to kind of demonstrate here are going to apply to most VPNs, okay? So things like kill switch split tunneling, protocols, locations and whatnot, most of these are going to be found in other VPNs, but this VPN tutorial will focus more on ExpressVPN and what is exclusive to ExpressVPN. Okay, so obviously, if you're looking for more information on ExpressVPN, you should check the review below. That'll give you more of an in-depth look into the privacy policy, speed, streaming and torrenting capabilities, as well as security and features. In this tutorial, and by the way, you'll also find a link in the description down below. That'll give you a little discount for ExpressVPN if you're interested in ExpressVPN. And keep in mind that no matter which plan you decide to go for, they're all guaranteed. They all are covered by a 30-day money-back guarantee, excuse me. So it is a risk-free kind of purchase if you'd like to just try out the first 30 days risk-free. All right. So when it comes to using ExpressVPN, as you can see here, it is very self-explanatory. It can be as simple as just, you know, you're going to download your application, you know, it's the same for your Android, your Mac, your iPhone. I'm on Windows right now. So yeah, it's all really the same thing. And the first thing you're going to see is this on and off button. And it can be as simple as, if you don't want to really mess with anything, it can be as simple as just turning on this on and off button. And that's pretty much it. This is how you use ExpressVPN. But of course, that's not what you're here for. I don't want to make this video too long, so I'll do my best to keep things as brief as possible, okay? On whatismyipaddress.com or whatever other website you want to use to check for your IP address, as you can tell here, we are in France as far as this website is concerned, okay? And of course, that's because I'm connected to a French server. Now, with ExpressVPN, you've got over 3,000 servers in 94 countries. So that is a lot of countries, making ExpressVPN a great choice for those of you that are maybe looking to unblock certain streaming services, maybe some obscure streaming services. So yeah, a lot of diversity when it comes to countries. Okay, now let's just turn this off real quick so that I can explain to you guys how to use this VPN. So besides the on and off button, you have a smart location here, recent locations, and your selected location. Now, what you can do to access your locations is maybe press the three buttons here, okay, and you'll have access to your locations. Or you can simply go to the options here, VPN locations, and you will get access to the locations here. Some recommended locations, recent locations, and recommended locations, depending on your own location, ExpressVPN will make some recommendations here. I am near the European region, so most of the recommended locations here are going to be European servers. And with regards to the United States, it's going to recommend a few United States servers, depending on my location. As you can tell, most of them are East Coast, except for Los Angeles. And that's because, you know, East Coast servers are going to be closer to me. All locations here, you'll find that they're all neatly kind of organized depending on continent. So yeah, this makes things very easy to navigate. Now let's go to the settings. Obviously you have a speed test feature here, saving you all that time you would have had to spend to manually test out these servers. This will kind of give you a rough aggregate of which of these servers is the best for you. Now the download speed may not be very accurate, but which server is the fastest for you, that is going to be the correct information that you're going to look for here. And down here, you can kind of select which servers or locations to test. You know, you want to test depending on continent or all locations. So yeah, this is a pretty useful feature that saves me a lot of time. Okay, now going back to the options here, there's really nothing else to mess with. So you want to go to the options, and here you can see all the startup options, network lock, and split tunneling. Now, these startup options are optional. You don't have to mess with that. And you've got the network lock, which is also known as the kill switch. Now, you can keep this on or off, you know, depending on your needs. The kill switch will stop your internet connection if the VPN disconnects unexpectedly. What this does is that this will make sure that you're only going to be connected to the internet only if you are connected to your VPN first. So you won't be connected to the internet unless you are secured by your VPN. So this can help prevent leaks, especially if you're in a censorship heavy country. And you've got split tunneling, which will help you manage or select which applications are routed through the VPN and which are not. So for example, you can have selected applications use the VPN while the rest of your connection is left intact or untouched by the VPN, or vice versa, where your entire connection is using the VPN tunnel, except for a few selected applications. So this can be very useful to a lot of you guys. Now, for protocols, you can go with automatic and that'll work 100% of the time. Especially some servers may not support some protocols, so you may select ICAF2, but obviously, as it says here, it may not work on all networks or all servers. So you can just go with automatic and that'll self-adjust, which works perfectly fine. I like to go with lightweight UDP, which is the best performing protocol. It works 99.9% of the time for me, so I just choose to stick with that. And once you kind of have an understanding that, you know, you can either go with automatic or lightweight UDP, you don't really need anything else. There's nothing in advanced that you want to mess with. In browsers, you can get browser extensions, but I prefer to use the application itself. You can set up some shortcuts, which can also be very useful. You've got protocols, account settings here, and your general, where you have your kill switch and split tunneling. Any VPN worth its salt should have a good proprietary protocol, a kill switch, as well as a split tunneling feature. And that's pretty much how you use ExpressVPN. Say you want to unblock a US Netflix library. Well, we're going to go to Americas, United States. Let's say Atlanta works perfectly well with US Netflix. So we'll just go with that and just turn it on. And in order to kind of double check that you are connected to the Atlanta server, and all you need to do is use some kind of IP address checker, refresh. In this case, I'm using this website right here, whatismyip-address.com. And there you go. I am in Atlanta. And there we go, I am in Atlanta. So it really is as simple as that when it comes to using ExpressVPN. Again, keep in mind, you do have a 30-day money-back guarantee if you would like to get yourself a refund, and they do have a 24/7 live chat support to help you with whatever problems you might be having, including the refund if you'd like to get yourself the refund. So that'll be it for this video. Again, links to special deals and discounts, as well as a full review, will all be in the description down below. Comment below if you have any questions. I'll be happy to answer all of them. Like and subscribe if you'd like to support the channel and stay up to date with everything VPNs and cybersecurity. Thank you guys very much for watching. I'll see you in the next one. Have a wonderful day.